Hey there and welcome to another Dave Does, and today we're doing a Dave Does reaction and we're checking out the band Cromok and the song is Obsessed. So before I get to that, apologies for the very sparse studio room. It's a little bit boomier in here as well sound wise. And a lot of that is just down to the fact that I'm actually moving properties. I wish I could say it was an upgrade. We're actually downgrading properties at the moment. So in the next couple of days, I'll be setting up the new smaller studio. It was small already. It's going to be smaller now. And all my the bulk of my guitars will be going into storage. But hey-ho, we're going to keep going and we'll find some new... some different things to do in the channel and we'll make the best of the new studio. So all the lighting was stripped out. I am literally down to just a... small little light above my head. All the backdrop's gone. Most of all the guitars have gone. I've literally just got a little bit of kit. Even my little zombie friend, he's gone. He'll be in the new property with a new friend as well, hopefully. But right, we're going to check out this Cromok. Now, the reason I'm doing Cromok rather than wait to go to the studio is we've got lots and lots of requests for Mystery, Misery, a ton of other bands as well. For one of the previous Cromok videos has gone really big. And has absolutely just kind of flown off over the last few days. So just a massive thank you to all the Cromok fans that have just recently subscribed. So this video is for you. This is probably one of the most requested tracks that you wanted me to check out. Before I do the video though, just a quick word from the video sponsor for today. Nothing Gains 2008 debut album, The Set, available via Bandcamp. Great tracks such as Underguard, Bane, Aware, Relic, Revolution, and Rotten Inside. All available for a physical CD shipped worldwide. Also available for digital download. Get yours today. Right, let's go. This is Cromok and Obsessed. I couldn't find a decent quality. I found some live videos, and I really wanted live videos, so I'm looking for high quality, like festival crowd type videos, which have got great mixes of as well. So if you know of any, please put it in the comments below and I'll check those out. So let's do this. Cromok, Obsessed. 3, 2, 1. Let's do this. You guys know I talk over the top. It's got a classic kind of 80s thrash style. There's nice some simple chord changes. Interesting there was a harmony to the lead. But I think it's actually only, I think it's just doubled up in the studio. Catchy track so far. I would say the production's not great. It's got a very 80s style of sound to the music. So what I'm hearing is the drums are really clicky. They've got real loads of beat impact points. This almost has like a kind of Scandinavian kind of folk. Vocally kind of reminds me a little bit of some of the earlier Sepultura. That kind of style of vocal. Not quite as deep, but.
Right?
Get us to that folk bit. Just a nice change up. This has got that kind of classic new wave of British heavy metal 80s vibe, Iron Maiden-esque. Okay, another change, alright, do that. It's that kind of cool, kind of classic, simple rock tempo that kind of gets you just head bobbing. This doesn't sound like it was recorded to a click. Just because there's a couple of tempo variations in the same tempo. Just like a beat per minute, I'll say the change, but interesting. Okay, so that was Cromok and Obsessed. Okay, it's a good track. Enjoyed it. It had a very classic 80s new wave of British heavy metal, that style of what we were kind of expecting. So it had all of the elements of the thrash genre. It had classic British heavy metal vibes to it at points as well. Took some of the influences of, like I was saying, about some of the sort of vocally the Sepultura, the more heavier elements versus the thrash, which I really enjoyed those, and I like the sort of time changes. As I said, I don't think it didn't sound at points where it might have been that there was a click used to record to, but there were some slight variations. It could have been that the click was being used, and that was one of the takes. They just went, you know, that was a great take, we're going to keep it, even if there was a slight wobble in the variation. So I guess I'd like to hear the track remastered with more modern techniques of recording. So the drums, basically you heard that constant, like that impact point, rather than the actual, as much of the actual drum itself. You're getting more of the click point of the hit, which is usually fine on something like the kick. You want to have a lot, you want to hear that click or the click pad, but you could hear it on everything, so everything was very clicky. And that could just be as simple as they didn't have a click pad and they just mic'd up, they took a total room mic style on things and then they kind of EQ'd it all afterwards. That could be the reason. Apart from that, cool track, I really enjoyed it. Vocally not always my sort of style. I'm probably a bit more of a cleaner vocal style that I prefer, but I can understand why people enjoy it. If you like this video though, please subscribe, click the bell icon, like and share. If you'd like to make a request for me to check out a song, please go down to the details down below. There's all those details. If you'd like to support the channel, you can do donations. There's the merch shop at the Rotten Inside shop. There's more stuff going to be going on there soon. You can buy the albums from Nothing Game, my previous band, and keep the support coming. Thank you very much, and that's of course how Dave does it.